Hi, I'm Elizabeth Hendrickson. My company is Curious Duck Digital Laboratory. I'm a consultant and I help software development leaders improve decision-making, collaboration, and execution. Today, we're going to explore one of the most enduring points of contention in software development, and that is the ideal model for staffing teams and allocating work. So is it better to have a cross-functional team of highly skilled specialists, where each specialist gets to focus on their area of specialty? Or is it better to have a team of generalists, where everybody knows a little bit of everything? I built a simulation to explore questions like this. So, let's get to it. It is the head-to-head battle of the generalists versus the specialists. In round one, we have two individuals. Min on the left is a specialist. Corinne on the right is a generalist. They each have 20 tickets in the backlog, and because this is a simulation and we can control everything, they have exactly the same work to do. You can see that Min is faster. In fact, she's about twice as fast as Corinne. When Min finishes, Corinne still has half of her work remaining. Round one goes to the specialists. But round one was just to show you that the specialists actually are faster in this simulation. So now on to round two. But wait, before we do round two, let me explain a little bit about the simulation. The animation you're seeing is actually a web interface on a Rails app. Behind the app, there's a simulation engine that I wrote in pure Ruby. The engine has a notion of teams and individuals and backlogs and work to be done. And with every clock tick in the simulation engine, the team members, agents in the simulation, work on their work in progress, deliver that work to the done column, or pick up new work from the backlog. The simulation engine has a notion of skill, as well as a bunch of other configurations we're not exploring in this particular scenario. The higher an individual's ability in a relevant skill, the faster they go. That's how Min is twice as fast as Corinne. Both Min and Corinne are agents in the simulation, and their speed is governed by their skill. So, back to the simulation. Round two! Here, we have two teams of three people each. Just like in round one, each specialist in the team on the left is twice as fast in their particular specialty as the generalist team members on the right. Each team has the exact same work to do in the same order, but specialists only pull work from the backlog that requires their specialty, while generalists pull whatever work is at the top of the backlog. So, which team will be faster? The specialist team, of course, this would make sense, right? In fact, it looks like they're almost done. They're going so fast, almost. They've just got to get this release over the line. But why aren't they making any more progress? Why are those people idle? What's going on? The generalist team is catching up. Round two goes to the generalists? Oh, that wasn't fair. There are four specialties, but only three specialists. The specialist team was short one specialty. And of course, the specialists only work on their area of specialty, so they couldn't finish the release. Okay, so we'll make the next round fair. Round three. Our two teams have four people each. The specialists team on the left has four specialists representing the four specialties in play, and the generalist team on the right has four people to make the count of people fair, but all of those people are still generalists. The specialists still go faster than the generalists. So now what's going to happen? And of course, round three goes to the specialists. That's not surprising at all. But the setup isn't realistic for a few reasons. First, each specialty has exactly the same amount of work, so the specialists all finish at exactly the same time. But in the real world, work is more lumpy. A given release is likely to require more of one specialty than another. Similarly, all the tickets are exactly the same size, but in the real world, each ticket will take a varying amount of time. Here, everyone's working all the time. No one ever goes out of the office or takes vacation. And finally, all of that work is pre-planned and splatted into the backlog before the work even begins. But in the real world, where we're doing incremental delivery, it's more common for the work to come in over the course of the release. In fact, even in organizations that think they planned all of the work in advance, the reality is the work ends up being replanned continuously because we know more about the work to be done with each passing day of having actually tried to do the work. So, the specialist team had a completely predictable win, but in a frictionless universe. It's what our intuition tells us will happen, so it's easy to understand why there are people who argue that teams will be faster and more efficient when staffed with a cross-functional team of experts who focus on their specialty. But enough of frictionless universes. Let's get messy. Okay, here's a more realistic scenario. Round 4. The work that each of the two teams is doing is still the same, but the distribution amongst the specialties and the arrival times of the work is much more lumpy. Also, team members take vacations. Just like in round 2, when the specialist team was short a specialist, the work in the missing specialty will languish in the backlog until the specialist comes back and is able to start working again. This is the problem with having a single person responsible for all of the work of a given type. In distributed systems, we have a saying, no single points of failure, no SPOFs. And that applies to organizational design too. Okay, so note that because the work arrives throughout the release and there is an uneven distribution of work, there are times when the specialists are idle, waiting for work that matches their specialty to show up. So, who wins in the end? It's the generalists, but only by a hair. I've run this same scenario many times. Sometimes the specialists win, sometimes the generalists win. So let's call this a tie. But wait, is this truly realistic? When you have these super experts in the organization, it seems ridiculous to have them ever sit idle. Let's make this even more realistic. The minute a specialist is idle, their manager assigns them extra work to make sure they stay busy. Have to maximize how we use time, after all. Oh, that's a lot of extra work that has nothing to do with the release. Look at all that extra work. The specialists are working very fast and they're getting a lot done. But to what end? What's the value in that extra work? This is why we say that outcomes are much more important than output, and productivity is a trap. In the end, the generalists finish the release long before the specialists. Round 5, generalists. Just goes to show how important focus is. So what have we learned so far? Even though it seems like a team of highly skilled specialists should be faster than a team of generalists, thanks to the messiness of reality, a team of generalists can still end up being faster than a team of specialists. And if you do want to staff a team with specialists in order to speed up a release, you have to let the specialists focus, even if that means they're idle and it looks like it's a waste of time. So let's consider one more scenario. A team of multi-skilled people, sometimes folks who have a deep specialty plus some other skills, are called T-shaped. Other words I've heard used include paint drip or broken comb. The key thing is that they don't only stick to a single area of specialty, they're growing other skills as well. So let's set up a team of T-shaped people where each person has a deep specialty in one of the 4 needed areas, but a generalist level of skill in the other areas. Now which team is faster? The T-shaped agents in the simulation pick up work in their specialty when it is available, but if it's not, they pick up from the top of the backlog. As a result, when someone on the T-shaped team goes out on vacation, the rest of the team can pick up their slack. So which team is faster? Round 6 goes to the T-shaped team. So what does all this mean? It means specialists versus generalists is the wrong debate. The specialist team wasn't actually a team. It was a collection of individuals. The T-shaped team actually functioned as a team where the team is the agent of work. A team is 2 or more people united by a shared mission with a set of working agreements about how they execute and a shared sense of success or failure. There is no, I did my part, I'm waiting on you. They're a team and they executed together. So there are limitations to what the simulation can model. I have taken pains to make the simulation account for the messiness of reality, but it is still just a simulation. As statistician George Box said, all models are wrong, some are useful. That said, I hope you've gotten some insight into how you might think about modeling the messiness of reality, given that once things get too messy, our intuitions are no longer very good at predicting what will happen. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this. Love to see you drop a note in the comments and reach out to me if there's a particular scenario you'd like to see the simulation model. Thank you.